فؤادك الأيام فتى.
الأصل الثاني: أمر الله بالاجتماع في الدين ونهى عن التفرق فيه.
Today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go into the second asl. The second asl in our great book, شرح أصول الستة لشيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب. The second asl, the second fundamental thing that is needed is that the person needs to know that it's obligatory, wujub, it is obligatory. الاجتماع على الحق. Pay attention. وجوب الاجتماع على الحق. That it's obligatory to unite upon the حق. والناهي. And that is prohibited. عن التفرق فيه. And that it's prohibited to differ in the حق. This is a أصل which is very important. The Sheikh said, أمر الله. Allah ordered. This is what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us what? بِالِاجْتِمَاعِ to unite. فِي الدِّينِ in the religion. وَنَهَا عَنِ التَّفَرُّقِ فِيهِ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala prohibited us of what? To differ within the religion. Allah prohibited us subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now what I'm going to do inshallah wa ta'ala is I'm going to mention to you all أَسْبَابُ الْإِخْتِلَافِ وَالتَّفَرُّقِ. What are the things that cause differing and to become groups and sects? What causes it? Before I go into the speech of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, I'm going to mention that, and then I'm also going to mention another point inshallah ta'ala after this. What are the things that cause people to differ, to be of groups and sects, and every single person to have his own banner, his own flag, and to say we're called this, and you guys are called that, and you're called that, and you're called that, and that's our names. What causes it? The first one is, ikhwani, is ittiba'ul hawa, following your whims and desires. If every single person follows his own whims and desires does not unite the people. Because every single person, his desires is different to the other person. He desires something different to the other person. ولذلك الله تبارك وتعالى said in the Quran, هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله. الله says فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ, those who have in their hearts deviation, whims and desires overcame them. What do they follow? They follow the verses which are ambiguous. Because they have desires in themselves, they won't go to the verses which are muhkam, the clear-cut verses. They will bring you ayat which are ambiguous, are unclear. What does Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mean by this verse? It has to be explained with another ayah. Because he has whims and desires filled in his heart. So he'll force you to go to these verses. And that is what makes people become groups and sects. The people become what? Firaqan, sects, by following their whims and desires. وَبِمُفَارَقَةِ الدِّينِ, and differing with the religion until they become what? And they become different nihal and sects. The second one, brothers, is, the second one is al-jahlu, ignorance. Ignorance, what does it cause, brothers? Ignorance is the things that causes al-ikhtilaf wa tafarruq. This people to differ and to be different, ignorance causes it. Min asbab al-jahli, causes of التفرق والاختلاف is الجهل بدين الله تبارك وتعالى, when the people are ignorant of the religion of Allah. والكلام في دين الله بلا علم, and the person starts speaking about the religion of Allah without knowledge. He has no understanding of the deen. ولذلك our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in the hadith of عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله تعالى عنهما, may Allah be pleased with Abdullah and may Allah be pleased with his father عمرو بن العاص. This hadith is narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim. And they're both of them in the authentic book, في صحيحيهما, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ, Allah does not take knowledge, إِنْتِزَاعًا يَنْتَزِعُهُ مِنَ النَّاسِ, Allah does not take knowledge which he takes away from the people. Allah does not take and lift knowledge from the people and take it away from their hearts. He doesn't do that. How does Allah take knowledge? وَلَكِنْ يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ بِقَبْضِ الْعُلَمَاءِ Allah takes knowledge by taking the people of knowledge, أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ Allah تبارك وتعالى, he takes the knowledge by taking its people who are carrying it. حَتَّى إِذَا لَمْ يَبْقَ عَالِمٌ Until there is no scholar left. اتَّخَذَ النَّاسُ رُؤُوسًا جُهَالًا And based on that, the people, they take the ignorant ones as their leaders. That's what they do. They start pointing towards an ignorant individual and they say, Shaykhuna, our teacher, so and so. فَسُئِلُوا And then the ignorant one is questioned. فَأَفْتَوْا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ فَضَلُّوا وَأَضَلُّوا They give fatwa, the jahil one gives a fatwa. And what happens? Without knowledge. فَضَلُّوا He misguides the people. وَأَضَلُّوا And they misguide themselves. He misguides himself and he misguides others. ولذلك I think it's Rabi' ibn Abd al-Rahman, Rabi' at al-Ra'i, Imam Malik's teacher. Imam Malik's teacher. And I believe it was him. Rabi' ibn Abd al-Rahman, Rabi' at al-Ra'i. He cried one day and they said to him, مَا يُبْكِيكَ What's making you cry? Pay attention to this speech. They said to him, why are you crying for? They saw him crying. And then he looked and he said, إِسْتُفْتِيَ الْيَوْمَ مَنْ لَا عِلْمَ عِنْدَهُ The reason why I'm crying is fatwa was asked to a person who has no knowledge. And is given fatwa. That is why I'm crying. That today on the earth there has come people who are giving fatwa. This is Rabi' Imam Malik's teacher. At that time there were people giving fatwa, passing rules of Allah's religion subhanahu wa ta'ala without knowledge. Without knowledge. And without understanding of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jahal. And then you see, subhanAllah, people who are giving da'wah, who are saying, we're calling to the religion of Allah, they don't even know the mabadi of the religion, the beginning, the fundamental matters of the religion, they don't know it. And they're out there giving what? Al-da'wah to ilallahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. They are calling to the deen of Allah. They are called what? Du'at. Callers to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what does that cause, brothers? It causes al-ikhtilaf wa tafarruq. ولذلك the Salaf, some of them used to say, لَوْ سَكَتَ مَنْ لَا يَعْلَمْ If he was to be silent, the one who doesn't know, if he was silent, and he closed his mouth, the one who doesn't know, what would have happened? لَقَلَّتِ الْخِلَافُ The dispute and the khilaf would have been little. If the jahil was quiet, and he didn't talk, and he let the scholars talk, and he left it to the scholars, then the khilaf would be little. But because everybody is contributing his thoughts, what do you think? What do you think? What do you think? What do you think? It has caused what? It has caused hundreds of views. Views of who lakin? Views of ulama? La. Juhal. Ignorant people. And so basically the people then they say, the scholars differed in this issue. What scholars differed in this issue? There's no scholars. Na'am. So, al-jahlu. Ignorance of the religion of Allah, ikhwani, is min asbab al-ikhtilaf wa tafarruq in the religion of Allah. One of the things also, brothers and sisters, is that causes al-ikhtilafu fi al-deen wa al-tafarruqi fihi is what? Al-i'timadu ala al-ma'quli. If a person relies on their intellect in taking the aqeedah fi akhdi al-aqeedah, when taking aqeedah, the person relies on his intellect. Wa tarki al-istidlali bil-manquli, and the person leaves off what? And the person leaves off looking for the textual evidences. He doesn't rely on the textual evidences. He relies on logic, intellects of people. These are the things that cause what? Why? Why would it cause it? Because the ara, the views of people, and the way that people's brains work, are they different or not? They're different. There has to be something that governs them all. What is it? Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about it later. Bi-idhnillah al-kareem. The things that govern us, ikhwani, is al-kitab wa sunnah. We're going to speak about that in the other point that I want to speak about, inshallah ta'ala. Also, brothers, من أسباب الاختلاف والتفرق في الدين. One of the things, brothers, that causes الاختلاف والتفرق في الدين is what? طعن في علماء السنة. Criticizing, slandering the scholars of the Sunnah. ومدح أهل الأهواء والبدع. And praising the innovators and the people of whims of desires. A person who's مبتدع, who's an innovator, who calls to innovation, you're praising him. And you're giving him a position. And you slander who? You slander the ulama, the حراس of the Sharia, the people who are standing to protect the Sharia, they are criticized and they're slandered. And Ahlul Bida'a, what? They are praised. These are from the things that are what? من أسباب الاختلاف والتفرق في دين الله. It is from the things, brothers, that cause what? It causes the ummah to disunite and to differ. People who are deviating the ummah from the straight path. Brothers and sisters, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, based on the hadith Ibn Majah narrated. Ibn Majah narrated on the authority of Ma'auf Ibn Malik. He's Auf Ibn Malik al-Ashja'i radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, I heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, I heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, افترقت اليهود على 71 فرقة. The Jews, they broke into 71 sects. فواحدة في الجنة وسبعون في النار. 70 of them are in the hellfire and one of them are in the paradise. وافترقت النصارى. The Christians, they broke into how many? على 72 فرقة. 72. فإحدى وسبعون في النار. How many? 71 of them are in the hellfire. وواحدة في الجنة and one is entering Jannah. والذي نفس محمد بيده. The Prophet then said, I swear by the Lord in which Muhammad, myself, the Prophet of Allah, whose hand, I swear by the one whose hand my soul is in. I swear by him, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Do we believe the Prophet without him having to say that? Yes. We already believe him. Imagine if he said this. He said this, we would have taken it from him even if he didn't say this statement, that I swear by the one whom my soul is in his hand. We would have taken it from him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he is sadiqul masduq. But imagine if he said it, it will become even what? It should be more serious to us. He said that, I swear by the Lord, my soul is in his hand. لَتَفْتَرِقَنَّ. They will break into. This is more tawqid. They will break in, and they will break, and they will break, and they will sect. My ummah will do عَلَى 73 فِرْقَةً. 73. They will turn into 73 sects, my ummah. واحدة في الجنة. Only one is in Jannah. وثنتان وسبعون في النار. And 72 are in the hellfire. قيل يا رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, who are the saved sect? Who are the one group that's going to enter Jannah? The Messenger said, الجماعة. الجماعة is what? الجماعة is the group. There's another riwayah, another narration, Tirmidhi narrated it, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Tirmidhi narrated in Sunan, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained who the jama'ah is. Who is this jama'ah? The Prophet in the other narration, what did he say? مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمَ وَأَصْحَابِي. Anyone who is upon that which I and my companions are upon today. Anyone who is upon that which I and my companions are what? Upon. Brothers and sisters, I want to ask you that question. Some of the scholars, some scholars weakened it, or it was weakened, the narration, مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمَ وَأَصْحَابِي. Some weakened it. That narration is strengthened by the narration of Al-Jama'ah. It's a shahid for the other narration. It strengthens it. Why? Because Al-Jama'ah at that time were who? The Prophet and his companions. Was there any other Jama'ah? La. So مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمَ وَأَصْحَابِي and Al-Jama'ah both mean the same. It's a tafsir and a bayan of the other narration. And it could be a shahid for it. Brothers, I want to ask you this question. Did the Prophet say more than one group is going to go to Jannah? Or one? It's only one. It's only one sect. And they are the saved sect. At-ta'ifatul mansura. So anyone who tells you, akhi, this group and that group and us, we all have different names. But don't worry, inshallah ta'ala, we're all getting to Jannah. La, there can only be one who's going to Jannah. From the 73 we know, only one is entering Jannah. And Imam Safarini, rahimahullah, in his Lawami' al-Anwar, he did a mistake here. And he goes clearly against the hadith of the Prophet. He even himself, rahimahullah, he done taraqud, he contradicted himself. On the issue of saying that the saved sect are who? He said it is a Sha'ira and the Maturidiyah and Ahlul Hadith. How could it be when the Prophet is saying it is what? If you ask a Sha'ira today, are you and the Maturidiyah? They'll say both of us. But the Prophet said what? It's one. It can only be what? One group. Now it brings me to the next point, inshallah ta'ala, brothers and sisters. We today find jama'at, ahzab. We have sects, groups, names. This is called Hizb al-Tahrir. This is called Ikhwan al-Muslimin. This is called Jama'at al-Tabligh. And the list goes on. All of them are saying, we are working to the establishing of Islam on this earth. And that we are all what? We are working to what? We are all working to the same. It's just that everyone is taking a different approach. Everyone is taking a different means. First of all, based on this hadith, we only know one is going to enter Jannah. Only one group is the Ta'ifatul Mansura, the saved sect. Now we have to ask ourselves, all of these groups that we find today, and those are not the only groups, there are more. Like in these, this is ala sabil tamthil. This is just an example of those who are out there right now. With these points, inshallah ta'ala, you will realize the answer of this question, because it needs to be explained in details. The first thing that we all have to ask ourselves is, when we dispute one another, and we differ on a matter, where do we go back to? If we differ on a matter, and we have different views on a matter, what is the marji'iyyah? Where is the source that we were ordered to go back to? Based on the ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. If you guys dispute one another in a matter, bring it back to who? Bring it back to Allah and His Messenger. If you are those who believe in Allah and the Day of Judgment, Surah An-Nisa, ayah 50, 59. So that ayah, Allah tells us to bring our disputes back to who? The Kitab and the Sunnah. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 83, Allah said, وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِّنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوِ الْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ اسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. Allah says, if a matter of good came to them, or a matter of fear came to them, they do ida'a, they will announce it. But Allah says, وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ, if only they brought their matter back to where? If they were to bring it back to, إِلَى الرَّسُولِ, to the messenger. وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ, and if they were to bring it back to the people of knowledge, the people who have authority over them, Allah says, لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said in the hadith that Imam al-Mundhir narrated in Targhib wa Tarhib, Shaykh Albani authenticated it there, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنِّي قَدْ تَرَقْتُ فِيكُمْ, I have left you guys with what? I have left with you مَا إِنْ اِعْتَصَمْتُمْ, something if you guys hold on to. فَلَنْ تَضِلُّ أَبَدًا, you will never be misguided. I have left with you something that if you guys hold on to it after my death, you will never be misguided. I have left something like that for you. The Prophet tells us what it is. Kitab Allahi, the book of Allah. Wa sunnata nabiyihi, and the prophetic tradition of the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. So, if we looked at what Allah has said right now, and what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, what was it that they told us? They told us, annarudda kulla khusumatin, every argument and every dispute and every differing that we have, we bring it, and nizaa, to bring it back to who? Ilallahi, to Allah. And wa rasulihi, His Messenger. To bring it back to Allah and His Messenger. If we do that, what will happen, brothers and sisters? وَحِينَئِذٍ تَزُولُ الْخُصُومَةِ, our dispute and our argument will what? It will uplift from us, inshaAllah ta'ala. And we will find our solution there. And the ayat that tell us to do that are immense. And that's غَيْضٌ مِّن فَيْضٍ. That's just a dip from the ocean. It's not all of it. Now the second point that we need to understand is, now that we've understood the Kitab and the Sunnah is our source, the second question is that the Kitab and the Sunnah, whose understanding are we going to base it on? This Kitab and the Sunnah that we have amongst ourselves right now, whose understanding are we going to base it on? Whose understanding are we going to base it on? We're going to base the Kitab and the Sunnah based on that which Allah tells us to base the understanding on. Allah has told us already who we need to base the understanding of the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 115, Allah said, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولَ, anyone who goes against the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's path, مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى, after clear evidence has come to him, and وَيَتَّبِعَ, and he follows, غير سبيل المؤمنين other than the path of the believers. He follows the path different to the path of the believers. Allah says, نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى. Whatever path you have treaded on and that you've taken, Allah will let you be on that path of destruction. And then what will happen? وَنُصْلِيهِ جَهَنَّمْ. And the hellfire will be your abode. And Allah then says, وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. What an evil place for you to stay. The hellfire, what a bad place for you to be. So, when this ayah came down, who are the people who were the believers at that time? Who were the mu'mineen of that time? وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Who had that statement, who had that name, mu'mineen? Us? We weren't even there. The believers of that time were the sahabas, رَضْوَانُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ. So anybody who follows a path other than the path of the believers, and it doesn't mean it's only the sahabas, but it means from them first. They are what? أَوْلَوِيَّةُ الدُّخُولِ. They're the first ones who enter the verse, because it came down when they were there. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said to us in the ayah, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا. If they believe, بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ. Allah said in this ayah, if they believe the way you guys have believed, فَقَدْ اِهْتَدُوا. They are guided. وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوا. If they turn away from you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your companions, what they are upon, if they turn away from it, فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاق. They are upon a deviated path. So the shiqaq here means al-bu'du, that you're distant from what? Manhaju Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ashabuh. You're far from the path of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions, ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, in the deen, in this religion. The third point that we need to realize, brothers, is, or that we need to ask ourselves is, are we allowed to believe something and then look for the evidence? Or do we look for the evidence first and then we believe it based on the evidence that comes to us? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala answers that for us. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Muhammad ayah 19, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says to us, fa'alam, know, first of all. Annahu la ilaha illallah wa astaghfir li dhanbik. Allah says to us, know that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. And then once you have the knowledge, وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ, ask Allah for forgiveness for your shortcomings. So what has Allah put first? Allah has put knowledge first. And Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, in his sahih, his authentic book, he chaptered a bab and he called it what? Babu, the chapter which is what? Al-ilmu qabla al-qawli wal-amal. Knowledge precedes speech and action. And Imam al-Bukhari's chapterings, brothers, barakallahu feekum, it's not an ordinary chapterings. The chapterings of Bukhari, the ulama, they say, فِقُّ الْبُخَارِيُّ. Imam al-Bukhari's fiqh, his rulings that he's extracting are based on his chapterings. When he chapters it, rahimahullah. So now Imam al-Bukhari, in that chaptering, he's trying to say to us that this is how it should be. That knowledge should precede any action or speech that you do. Don't call the people to the religion of Allah. Don't preach if you don't have knowledge. Don't act if you don't have knowledge. Don't believe if you don't have knowledge. Have knowledge of it. Why? Because knowledge precedes it. So you have a belief of a system and you believe batil and then you're looking for evidences. Are you going to accept it? You're not going to accept it. And that is min alamat ahlil bid'ah. Signs of the people of innovation, they believe something first. And then they go out of their way to look for what? To look for the evidences. So you look for the evidences from the Kitab and the Sunnah and the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah before you start believing in it. Before you what? Before you start to believe in it. ولذلك the scholars, they say that this, what do they do? يَعْتَقِدُونَ ثُمَّ يَسْتَدِلُّونَ فَيَضِلُّونَ. They believe, then they look for the evidences and then they become misguided. أهل السنة are what? يَسْتَدِلُّونَ ثُمَّ يَعْتَقِدُونَ فَيَهْتَدُونَ. They look for that. They look for the guidance first. Then they believe on the evidences that came to them from the Kitab and the Sunnah and on the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. Based on that, they start to believe now. Based on that, they start to believe. Good. Did the Sharia, point number four, did the Sharia place for us a way to call to the path of Allah? Did our Sharia Did it place for us a methodology to go to the path of Allah? Of course it did. Surah An-Nahl, ayah 125, Allah says, Udru, call to, ila sabila rabbika bil hikmati wal mu'idhati al-hasana. Call to the path of your Lord. Udru ila sabila rabbika, call to the path of your Lord, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, with wisdom. Wal mu'idhati al-hasanati, and with good reminders. Mu'idhati al-hasana. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, tabarak wa ta'ala, before I bring the ayah, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari said, rahimahullah, ادعو الى سبيل ربك بالحكمه والموعظه الحسنه. What does it mean? Ibn Jarir al-Tabari said it means هو ما انزله عليه من الكتاب والسنه. Call to the path of Allah based on what? Ibn Jarir said it is that which Allah has sent down from the book and the sunnah, the Quran and sunnah. When you're calling, you have the Quran and the sunnah with you. You're saying قال الله قال رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم, and this is the understanding of the salaf of this ummah, and this is how they understood it. Good. Very good. So, the da'wah our sharia has placed for us based on the ayah, what we need to call to the people. What are we calling the people to? The kitab and the sunnah. On what understanding? My understanding? The 21st century understanding? Everyone open the mushaf and try to see what you get out of it, and based on that we make our da'wah? Or everyone, let's revise, or let's do a new manual guide for da'wah. Is that what we're going to do? La. This is a manhaj you have to follow. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. That is my path. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي. This is my path. My path in terms of speech. My path in terms of action, my path in terms of belief, my path in terms of how I call the people to. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمٌ. My path is straight. It's مُسْتَقِيمٌ. فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. Follow that path. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ. Don't follow a group. Don't follow a group. What will happen to you? وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. It will deviate you from the straight path. It will deviate you from what? The path that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the Prophet recited the ayah, he not only did he say it to the Sahabas, but the Messenger took a twig. عليه الصلاة والسلام, based on the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, the Prophet took a twig. خَطَّ لَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ خَطًّا مُسْتَقِيمًا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ. The Prophet took a twig. He made a straight line on the path, and on the sides of it, he made lines that came out of it. And then the Messenger recited the ayah. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ سُبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِي. Don't follow these paths that are deviated from my straight path. Don't follow it. What will it do? It will deviate you. It will corrupt your mind. And now we find people who made the da'wah. If Islam is going to lift his head, akhi, be part of those who do or participate in parliamental elections. Elect. That's how Islam's going to lift its head. Did the Messenger do that, alayhi salatu wasalam? Was his da'wah in Mecca? Be part of the Ahlul Shura of Quraysh, or to be part of, or sit down with Quraysh and to be part of their committee in order for Islam to gain a government? Is that what the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, did? Abadan. He never done it, alayhi salatu wasalam. So brothers, the way it is that the Shari' had placed the da'wah should be, which is al-kitab wa sunnah bi fahmi salaf al-ummah.